We are continuing our meditation on the Westminster Confession of Faith, looking at the fourth section, chapter 8, on Christ the Mediator. The confession reads as follows. This office the Lord Jesus did most willingly undertake, which that he might discharge, he was made under the law, and did perfectly fulfill it, endured most grievous torments immediately in his soul, and most painful sufferings in his body, was crucified and died, was buried, and remained under the power of death, yet saw no corruption. On the third day he rose from the dead with the same body in which he suffered, with which also he ascended into heaven, and there sitteth at the right hand of his Father, making intercession, and shall return to judge men and angels at the end of the world. The confession here highlights a couple of things about Christ's work as our mediator. We, in our past meditation, focused on the fact that he took on our humanity in order to achieve our redemption. He could not just simply will it from heaven, or just appear for a period of time as an angel or a ghost or what have you, but he had to take on our humanity because a man must suffer for a man's sin. That's what justice requires. Equal treatment under the law. And so a man had to die for man's sin. Now we've also seen that Jesus was not merely man, but he was also fully God. So the worth of that offering could be sufficient to atone for not only one individual's sins, but for the sins of all those for whom he died. It is a unique, powerful offering for sin that Christ provides at the cross. No other religion offers anything like this. You will not find a mediator like this anywhere else, whether it is in Islam, in Hinduism, in Judaism, anywhere else. Only Jesus is the one mediator uniquely equipped for this role and office. In this chapter, we focus on a couple of elements with regard to his offering of himself. And the first is that it was given willingly and voluntarily. He went to that cross freely for you and I. He was not compelled to do that. He was not forced by the forces of nature or the dimensions of politics or religious bigotry or what have you. He went freely to that cross. At any moment in time, he could have walked away. He could have left it all behind. But he voluntarily endured the sufferings of the cross for you. So he loves you. Powerfully loves you. He went through all those sufferings freely and voluntarily for your sake, so that you would be delivered from sin and death, delivered from the wrath of God for sins. And so the confession rightly notes that he went to that cross most willingly. And he went to the cross under the law, fulfilling the law and all of its demands. First, in terms of his own perfect obedience to that law. Jesus was subject to the law of God. He was subject to the law of Moses and the Ten Commandments and all our obligations. He observed that law fully and faithfully throughout the whole course of his life. And it's that perfect righteousness that he observed in the course of life that now stands for us. That stands in our place now. And by remaining obedient through death, not only to the law, but also to the special commission that he had as our mediator, he provides for us a perfect and complete righteousness that fully answers all the demands of God's law and justice for us. So when we stand before God, we don't stand and present our good works, our righteousness, or anything that we might hope to think is sufficient. Rather, we stand underneath Christ's righteousness. And that perfect righteousness is ours through faith. And so that comes through his perfect obedience under the law. He obeyed it fully, even to the point of enduring the grievous torments of the cross. Now, the cross was not merely an injustice for were sin. It was not merely an evil work on the part of the politicians and the religious figures of that day in crucifying an innocent man. It was also the means by which God punished our sins. That cross, in all of its indignities and all of its injustice, was where God's justice was perfectly satisfied. And so when Jesus bore those pains and sufferings, he did that so that he could bear the pains and sufferings that were due to his people, for us who believe in him. He bore the full wrath of God there at the cross for us. There is no more wrath to experience, no more judgments to endure. We are justified in Jesus Christ. There is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because he is our perfect mediator, who in justice fulfilled God's law for us and in justice suffered on our behalf by enduring God's just sentence against us for our sins. God's justice was further seen in the fact that he was raised on the third day from the dead. Death could not keep its prey, as one of our hymns celebrates. Jesus rose from the dead because he fully answered God's just demands, and now his righteousness is complete. He is raised as God's servant and enters into heaven to be our king and leader, and he rules over us in glory even this day. He sits at the right hand of his Father. And we should note, the ascension of Jesus and his heavenly session is ongoing now. He is now at this moment the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He now rules the heavens and the earth. He rules all that takes place in human history and time. That is taking place now. And he's building his kingdom on earth, even now, as the great King. So with all the troubles and sorrows and difficulties of life, you can look up and see Jesus ascended in heaven, now ruling over all. And Satan is under his control. He cannot do anything more than what Christ authorizes him to do. His power is restricted. Christ is King, and he rules at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us, praying for us, for our needs. And finally, the confession concludes by saying that he will return to judge men and angels at the end of the world. We will look at that more fully later on in our study. But note that the confession knows this grand climax to all things when Christ returns at the end of history and judges all men at that one moment in time. History will come to its conclusion. Christ will appear in the heavens, all men will see him, the dead will be raised, the righteous will be clothed with immortality, the wicked will be raised, and they will all stand before the judgment seat. The righteous will be separated from the wicked will receive their just condemnation and will be sentenced to an eternal hell for sins against an infinite God. And they will forever pay the penalty for that because of their sin. But we who have seen the danger of the wrath of God have found a mediator in Jesus who satisfies the wrath of God for us. And so that judgment will be a time when we receive God's full justification and we enter into life eternal because of Jesus Christ. This is your mediator. We need a mediator to stand between us and God. And apart from Jesus, there is no hope. So pay close attention and turn to Jesus and find in him all that you need for life, for salvation, and for your eternal well-being.